won't last very long. You'll just startle it.
All right, boys and girls and people that watch, probably just boys, don't mean to be sexist there. Welcome to winter. Which is funny because the funny part about us doing winter right now is the fact that the first episode of this, of the winter, is coming out on Wednesday, December 21st, which is the first day of winter, ironically enough. I totally planned that on purpose. Right? No, I actually didn't. That's just a really funny coincidence. But it's funny, when I decided to start this series like around Halloween, I thought, you know what would be funny? If the timing makes it so winter begins around winter. I knew that was gonna happen. Oh shit, we should be following those deer tracks, shouldn't we? Huh. I was busy talking my own stuff, I wasn't following the tracks. Yeah, it's a bit open here right now, though. It's really empty, like super duper empty. There's nothing to do. All we have to do is follow tracks. But at least it gives us like some sort of exploration sort of thing, even though we don't really need it. I believe we have to go this way, because the other way is where we came from. But yeah, like, I knew it'd be around winter. Wait, where did these tracks go? Hold on. Okay, the tracks ended here. Does that mean it's... No, okay, no, deers can't climb on trees. What am I thinking? Or is those my own track? No, it's not my own tracks. Whatever, let's just go forward. Maybe we don't need to follow. Maybe it's not open. Oh, geez, we probably should not go down there. Okay, where do we need to go? Oh, maybe I was going the right way. Maybe I have to go up here. I don't think this is where I came from, actually. Yeah, I think I came from there. Yeah, so let's follow this way and figure out where we need to go. Though, I swear to God, if this is us backtracking again, that's going to be super annoying. I can't tell if we're back. No, I'm pretty sure this is where we came from. Yeah, I think it is. Whatever, just follow. Maybe it's not. Oh, there you are. Oh, I guess I have to be, like, super stealthy. I guess we have to be stealthy here so we can catch that deer. Oh, dear. But, yeah. I knew it was going to be around winter, but I had no idea that we'd actually get this up on the exact day of winter. I didn't even know that the winter day winter begins was a Wednesday, Friday, or Sunday, which I find hilarious how that timing worked out. But, okay, so another thing I want to talk about. Even though, this seems kind of boring right now. We're just following a track. What's coming up? This makes winter the best part of the game for me. You'll see what's coming up. Like, spoilers. It gets really, really cool. No pun intended. I swear. I not intend that pun. Maybe I did on purpose. It just, like, came out. Like, I subconsciously intended it, but I didn't actually intend it, if that logic makes any sort of sense. Okay, let's go in this cave. That is not a cave. That is just a rock. Okay, where do these tracks go? We are on the right track. Yeah, that was kind of intended. It's weird. With me and puns, they just come out for me. Like, the puns come out for me. Like, I don't actually plan them. I don't think of them. It's just natural to me. And sometimes I can't help it. Like, it's just instinct. I think I have a pun addiction. It'd be funny if there was some sort of pun for saying you have a pun addiction. But there's not. If there is, let me know in the comments. And man, I've been talking a lot. This is like... It's weird, just controlling Ellie, and without a story-driven part, like, left behind, makes it, like, so, like, it feels like commentary's weird now that I actually get to talk for more than, like, 2 minutes at a time without being interrupted. Okay, I think I saw it behind here, so... Huh, maybe I didn't. And, I guess another thing I want to talk about is, shit! I have to be- You know what, I'm just gonna cut to when I get it, because I'm pretty sure I'm just, like, failing. Okay, here we go. Ready, aim, and press the wrong button. Fire! Gotcha. Yeah, chair wrecked. Okay, let's see where you went. Maybe we'll have to sneak up in it again. But yeah, I hate winter. Like, I really, really hate it. Like, I don't even get why people like it. Like, sure, it's the prettiest season. Like, it's actually, like, winter I find the most beautiful season. But to me, I'd rather not be freezing to death and getting sick every other week. I'm not sure if you can notice, but I still have some sort of cold that I've gotten like a month ago because of how friggin' cold it is. than it being pretty. Like, it's more important for me to be healthy than to be surrounded by prettiness. And it's not even that pretty. It's only pretty when it's snowing, which is like every couple days or so, at least for me. I just despise winter. I hate being cold. I hate having to dress up like warmly. I hate being limited what I could do. I like to go on runs in the summer, but I can't do that in the winter, so I'm just being all lazy. Like, winter encourages me to stay indoors and be lazy. I don't like that. The summer encourages me to go outside. Like, I don't like being a hermit, but I feel like I got to be more quiet. I don't like being psychologically conditioned to want to be indoors all the time, because I prefer being outdoors. Which is weird coming from a gamer who's typically being indoors, but I don't know, I like the outdoors a lot more, though I do love gaming too. I like both, really. I like a balance. I don't like one or another, but I like having options. That's my thing. I like having options. And with winter, I don't have the option to go outside without either, like, dressing up super thick or, like, freezing to death and possibly getting sick. It's really annoying. I hate it. And I hate snow, too. Snow is pretty, but, like, it's coarse and smooth. And no, I'm not going to make a Star Wars reference. I just hate snow because of how annoying it is to walk in it. You have to wear boots, and boots are ugly. Boots are really ugly. At least my boots are. And they're heavy. And they are just not fun to wear, and you get snow everywhere, then you have to, when you get inside, you have to dry your feet off, and I'm gonna stop bitching about the winter. I just really hate winter so much, but it's amazing in The Last of Us. But you wanna know why it's amazing? Wait, did I get that thing? I can't tell. I think I did. But you wanna know why winter is amazing in The Last of Us? Because of how annoying it is. That way it makes it more of an obstacle for Joel and Ellie. Because not only do they have to fight they don't have to fight just zombies and the humans, but they also have to fight the conditions they are in. Even though we're not really fighting much conditions right now. It's not like there's a mechanic how we can't freeze to death. And by the way, look at what Ellie's wearing. How is she not freezing to death? She's just having a light sweater. Like, Jesus, you need a thick coat in the winter. Is it just not like, I forget what country this takes, I know it takes place in the United States. I forget what state this takes place, but it's just not that cold there, but it has to be cold for the winter. I know, I just really, really hate winter. Yeah, how are you still alive? This is actually kind of boring in my opinion. Like, even though winter is the best part of the game, this part is really, really boring. Not gonna lie. But I think it's gonna get good right now. Let's jump over this fence and no cutscene, huh? Yeah, like, who thought that, like, oh, we're gonna have a mechanic where you can hunt deer in a zombie apocalypse game? Who thought this was a good idea? I guess it's fun for, like, a survival open world game. But it's not fun right now. Just freaking hide and seek. Who thought this was a good idea? This is not fun at all. Or maybe I'm just, like, incredibly angry. Maybe I'm just incredibly angry right now after constantly ranting about the winter, so it's made me angry. And at least... Ha, it's funny because there's snow everywhere and it's cold. Why is she talking to herself? Oh god, the deer is dead.
Who's there? Come out!
Hello? We just want to talk.
Any sudden moves and I put one right between your eyes. Ditto for buddy boy over there. What do you want?
Name's David. This here's my friend James. We're from a larger group. Women, children. We're all very, very hungry.
So am I. Women and children, all very hungry too.
Well, maybe we could trade you for some of that meat there. What do you need? Weapons? Ammo? Clothes?
Medicine! Do you have any antibiotics?
We do. Back at the camp. You're welcome to follow us.
I'm not following you anywhere. Buddy boy can go get it. He comes back with what I need. The deer is all yours. Anyone else shows up...
You put one right between my eyes.
That's right.
Two bottles of the penicillin and a syringe. Make it fast. Go on.
I'll take that rifle.
Of course.
Back up.
It's probably gonna be a while. You, mind if we take some shelter from the cold?
Bring him with us.
There.
You know, you really shouldn't be out here all on your own.
I don't like company.
I see. What's your name?
Why?
Look, I understand it's not easy to trust a couple of strangers. Whoever's heard, you clearly care about them. I'm sure it's gonna be just fine.
We'll see. You had another gun?
Sorry. Yeah, I'd really like my rifle back now.
No, you have your pistol.
You know how to use that thing.
I've had some practice.
No matter what, we have to keep them out. Let's hope they don't find him. Cover the windows.
Okay.
Oh man, time for some gameplay. What's interesting? Okay, are we supposed to be covering the windows or something? Oh, I see. We just have to stay and follow and do. And make sure we hit everyone and kill everyone. But what's interesting? Oh, did that guy? Did David just like clip through me? Oh god. Okay, no, you die. Thank you, David. So what's interesting about David is he is voiced by Nolan North, who is it's very interesting for a few reasons. Not because I suck. I should have been covering those windows. I expected him to do it though. Okay. Shit. Okay, come at me, bro. Okay, you're dead. Okay, I need a new weapon. Okay, no, he gave me more. Cool, infinite ammo, sure.
You weren't kidding! You're a better shot with that thing than I am! Give me a hand with this.
Oh, come on!
Oh god! You get a shotgun, and you get a shotgun. Okay, no, you're through. Shit, this is a problem. This is actually kind of a fun mechanic, like this set piece. It's really interesting having to hold the windows. It's like a real zombie apocalypse game. And oh Jesus Christ, clicker. Okay, good. Thank you, David, for covering me.
More people on this side. They must have followed.
Oh god, clicker! I died! I was busy looking through the window. I didn't notice the clicker getting through here. Come at me, clicker, bitch. You're dead. Okay, where are the rest of the runners? Okay. Probably should keep an eye out here. I'm just scared they're gonna like sneak up on me like before. Oh, another clicker. Okay, you're dead. So the interesting thing about David being played by Nolan North is the fact that Nolan North is a very iconic voice actor. And he's where's the clicker? I hear it. Oh god. Okay, you get knifed in the back. Or by the back, I mean the head. I think there's a clicker in here! I'm so scared. I am very terrified. I think there's a clicker. I can hear it. Oh no, that's just me being paranoid. And do you know who's also another iconic voice actor? Troy Baker. And Troy Baker plays Joel, the lead of this game. So we have two incredibly iconic voice actors in one game, which is really funny, but like, Troy Baker's not even here to greet him. Oh god, I need to run. Okay, they're chasing after me. Okay, give me the hard part, bitch. That's not very nice. Okay, at least you didn't get in.
Oh,
through here.
Okay. Do you know where you're going? Great.
It's clear. This way.
Right behind you.
How are you holding up?
You don't need to worry about me.
All right. Stay close. Hey, kid, you all right?
I'm fine.
You flickers. Get out of there!
I like on the top part of that area. Oh god, clicker! Oh, that was clutch. Add another clicker, okay? We're running out of ammo. Oh my god, there's like four clickers ever. Maybe I should just run away from them. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna be very stealthy right here. I'm not gonna like try to kill them all. That's just a silly idea. Let's go through here and see if we can get around the clickers. Because there's like five of them. We don't wanna take them on. Oh god! Okay, at least we knifed that one. And there's another one right here. I think there's only, oh no, there's three. Alright, let's see if we can sneak up on this one without it noticing me. I like how the top part looks exactly like the area we were with Tommy at his holdup, his settlement place. Like, yeah, as I said, this game likes to reuse a lot of set pieces and make it look slightly different, which is fine, because this game's amazing. They gotta save their budget somewhere. And it's not even too noticeable, just me, who's, like, very nitpicky on level design and whatnot. That's probably, like, okay, that was not a good idea. I shouldn't have just jumped down there. I thought I could have knifed it, but that didn't work. I guess we'll just jump down here instead of worrying about the third clicker. So yeah, another funny part about Nolan North being in this game is not just the fact we have the two most iconic voice actors of all time in the Western video game industry being in one game, but also Nolan North is the lead of the Uncharted series, which is Naughty Dog's like other flagship title. And it has very, very similar gameplay style to The Last of Us. It's a very similar concept. They're both third-person shooters that mix in stealth and action a lot. So it's funny having both those guys in the same game.
We're so close. We need to get up there. There. That ladder could work.
The tricky part about being a commentator of The Last of Us is when you want to talk about an anecdote to like help make the commentary a bit more lively, you get interrupted a lot by them talking or the cutscenes, and I'm very anal about showing off as much as I can in terms of the dialogue because that's my favorite part of the game. I'm also anal about talking when it's not needed because right now I'm doing that when I want to get that ladder. So I'll figure out what I need to do. Aha! I saw the triangle prompt. Here. Let's get up here.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
You be quick. Keep a lookout.
I know.
Because I said this in the beginning of the project, but my goal for each Let's Play is to always, like, I have a different goal for each Let's Play. As, like, a thesis statement, if you will. And, oh god. Oh my god! Where did that come from? That freaking scared the shit out of me! Oh my Jesus Christ. And why do they have, like, purple suits, these clickers? There you are. I freaking see the clicker this time. They just got a little gunshot on it. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna use the bow and arrow. Because it should one-shot it. And dead. Okay. And there we go. Takes care of that there. Is there another clicker near me? Because I hear it. It may be below me, but I can't tell. Let's go in here and make sure we don't get ambushed. Okay. Oh my god, I was so scared that there would be like another clicker on the floor or something. Yeah, you saw the pendant. Let's open it again just so we can flip it around and see what it's like. Just a typical Firefly symbol. And now here's all, I just want to show this off. Here's a bunch of Ellie's thing. A lot of these are references to the DLC I showed off. I'm like Riley's pendant. You saw her get that. It's cool how they actually, and the joke book that she gave you. It's actually cool how they planned maybe they didn't, they just threw stuff in and they decided to make the DLC later based on the artifacts. No, but I'm pretty sure they had this whole backstory planned out and then they decided to show it off in DLC. Or maybe they planned that from the beginning. that they wanted to actually do a DLC expansion with Untold Stories. Who knows? It's probably not necessary, but I'm gonna shoot this clicker and kill it, because why not? It's vulnerable, can't hit me, so there you go. It's a waste of arrows. I feel like I wasted my supply, but whatever. Let's just drop this down on Nolan North. And also, I noticed that Ellie always has to have a companion, or so does Joel. Like, first Joel had Tess, then he had Ellie. And now that Joel's gone, we have Nolan North as his companion instead. Fine, I'll call him David. That's his actual name. But I'm in the habit of, like, when there's a big name, like, actor as, like, a guest star, not as the main character, I pretty much consider David a guest star. I like to call them by their names. Okay, I'll check that body. I'll check these bodies in a second, because I have a feeling it's going to trigger an event. So before, I just want to get around and collect some supplies. Because I mentioned this before, but anytime an area seems familiar, I think I always associate with it being hard. And I remember this part, and I remember this area all too well. I remember exactly what happens. So I'm pretty sure what's going to go down is going to be a really hard section. We'll have to see. Like, I remember that bloater fight. I remember the electricity in the DLC, even though that wasn't really hard at all. I don't know why I remember that so well. Who knows? So let's check these bodies.
Jeez. Looks like someone already fought those things and lost.
Oh, Lord. I've been looking for these boys. Doesn't matter. Grab the gear. And look for an exit.
Okay, I guess this didn't trigger a cutscene, or maybe it did. Maybe it did trigger an event. Nolan North is about to go do something. Sorry, okay, I paused by mistake, derp. And you can tell my battery's almost dead, which is weird, because I have it plugged in. I don't know why it's dead. Is there something wrong with my micro USB cable or something? And, I was debating between a Molotov and another health kit.
So what do we do?
We hold our ground.
Is there any other choice?
We die.
Get ready.
Let's go. I'm gonna get a bomb out just so we can, like, when they come rushing in, I'll just bomb them all to death. Okay, so okay, there. Now we're gonna shoot you. And down goes that guy. I think I wasted my bomb. I don't think anyone's there. I think it was just one person that ran in. Literally one person. Okay. Shit, I missed. Okay, there goes that guy. I'll save the other bomb for when more people rush in at the same time, because right now I don't think there's that many. But where are they going to come from? Because, okay, there's a clicker here. I didn't notice. Okay, down goes the clicker. And here comes another clicker. And I love how they have winter jackets. It's so funny seeing clickers with winter jackets.
I know.
I'll knife him because I can. Take that Molotov cocktail, because that's going to be useful when I'm pretty sure a bloater is going to show up. I mean, when you ever have a huge zombie encounter, there's always a bloater that shows up. Okay, that clicker goes down, because it's pretty scary. And I guess we'll knife that guy, because David, I nearly said Nolan North again, but I said David. I just realized, does the pocket knife have durability? Wow, this is easy so far. Okay, I'm going to shoot you. You're dead. Okay, where are the rest? Oh, God! I didn't realize they were coming from the other side. Okay, you get knife. I'm gonna take the shotgun ammo. Okay, fine. I'm gonna stop commentating over exactly what I'm doing. That's boring comment. I learned recently that's really boring commentary. I knew that from the get-go, but, like, after I heard someone say it in a video, I was like, man, I should really stop doing that even more.
It doesn't feel like
yeah, we're doing...
Stay focused. We'll make it.
Yeah, we're doing fine because this is freaking easy. Like, literally one are coming at the time. Show me, like, 10. Like, show me, like, 10 clickers and a bloater. Then we're gonna talk about being difficult. Maybe I should increase the difficulty again. But no, then I fear I'm gonna get wrecked. So what are we waiting on anyway? Oh. Oh, I see. We were waiting for the game to load. I love how that zombie tripped. Shit, I missed. Okay, whatever. Man, my knife is almost done. Okay, oh god. Where did that come from? Bombs away! Let's see if it kills anyone. I doubt it. Okay. But that will. This gun will. Okay, there goes down this one. Okay, you get sliced in the friggin'. You're not dead yet? Are you serious? Die, God, it's so annoying. Why can't they just, okay, knife, and you're dead. Okay, I guess we'll grab, okay, no, not yet, we need to, oh my God, clicker! Die, clicker, okay, good. Phew, this is getting really stressful right now, because I don't know where they're coming from. Like, that's the hard part, though. I think we've, oh my God, I hear a clicker, where is it, okay, there you are, clicker, and you're dead, clicker.
That doesn't sound good.
It's a bloater!
A what?
One of those big fucking guys!
Oh, fun. See, I friggin' called a bloater was gonna come. But whatever, we are gonna mullet. My controller died. I'll be back. That was very anticlimactic. Alright, die, bloater! A little fire just instant kills it, though. I don't think it's dead yet. Oh, no, I think it's gonna die. Okay, now we just need to deal with the other stuff. We'll let the bloater just die there. Okay. Oh, God, the bloater's alive! It's friggin' alive! Okay, you're gonna get another Molotov. Die! I set myself on fire by mistake. That worked. Or did I set David on fire? There's the bloater. There you are. Okay. You know what? The thing I learned about the bloater is what makes it easier is you need to go from behind to kill it. Okay, but... okay, where is this freaking bloater? I need to... okay, I'm gonna freaking kill it. I'm gonna wreck it. I'm gonna wreck you, bloater. Well, I guess I'll just use the freaking bomb to kill it. Hopefully that deals with it. Oh, God, nope. It's gonna throw its own spores at me. I think I'm gonna get to safety so I can friggin' use this health kit that I have. I crafted two and I can't even, you know what, no, I can't resist this temptation. I'm right behind it, so, and down goes the bloater. Okay, good. Now we are going to heal up and let's go back in here and just collect a bunch of things.
Like we killed all of them? More like disbelief.
That was relatively somewhat challenging, not really. It might have been easier for like people that actually knew what they were doing and doesn't suck at games like me. Though I knew what I was doing. I'm just terrible at everything. But I mean, that wasn't so bad. I remember like being stuck on here for like an hour or so. But that wasn't so bad.
Listen.
No infected.
No infected. What'd I tell you? All right, let's head on back. Check on that buck of ours.